Hi there and welcome back to Kona. This is part 5. In the last part we found a few missing items, but we also found some new items and some new clues, and we found the ice cave and explored it and discovered new things. So let's go ahead and continue this story. Alright, we're at the general store where we saved the game last time. And I'm trying to actually explore those houses below the store, or south of the store. La Chance, Bedard, and Roy. So three houses I want to go see. And hopefully find some more clues to find out what's going on here in this town.
Carl felt that the store and its surroundings still held their secrets, and he didn't like to miss out.
All right, we should be there soon. Oh, looks like there's a path. Huh, I didn't know that. I took the harder way. Oh wow, what's this? Another frozen person at La Chance house. La Chance, La Chance. I don't know. It's like a guy. Ugh. Creepy. They have a nice view from up here though. Pretty cool. So let's see what we can find out here. There are just some logs.
The air was freezing right down to the bone.
I bet I can touch this ice sculpture too.
The otherworldly ice had struck again. The woman's hopes and dreams were frozen in eternity. Something was hidden under the stairs. The man grabbed his rifle. Carl felt a sense of dread in him. Perhaps their spousal relationship had been cooling down lately. It seemed like secrecy was commonplace in this house. The vision's veil was lifted. And he was back to reality. A reality in which Giselle, Jill's loving spouse, was motionless, frozen in ice.
So it looks like Giselle was together with Gillis, the store owner, who is now dead. And he apparently was not very smart, but he was good at blackmailing. And he was thinking about blackmailing Hamilton. Alright, what do we have here? Some paintbrushes. Looks like they were repainting the whole house. And we can fill up another bottle with water. Still not sure what we need water bottles for, but we'll find out. Pretty sure sooner or later we will find the reason for it. There's no toilet paper. What's that? Oh, painkillers. I haven't had a use for those yet. Hopefully I never need them. So there's some cleaning materials. Oh, look at that. That light switch sure would have helped. Let's take one more look to make sure I didn't miss anything. Since we now have more light. Nope, seems like I got it all. All right, and there's a light switch here too. What a concept.
Looks like the holes in that puzzle are there to stay.
So what else do we have here? Oh, tons of cabinets. Food, and cups, and some more food. And utensils. Playing cards. Oh, there's something. It looks like a fire starter. Fire starter. Awesome. Let's be all tidy and close everything again. I don't think I'm cold, so I'm gonna wait with the fire and save those fire starters or matches. I have yet to find a clock that works. Huh. True. What's in the fridge? Ooh, steak. And tons of drinks.
The pot was cold, and the stew inside wasn't cooked. It's likely that poor Giselle was slow cooking it before she got snapped. Ah, moving. What a pleasant activity. Of course, you'll find the record player only to find the records weeks later in some random box.
Okay, let's see what's in here. That's what we saw in our dream. All right. There's numbers and letters. Letter is probably B for this house. I'm gonna try that, and then the numbers are 739. Okay, that's what I found on that necklace. I'm just gonna try that. I'm not sure if that's it, but I hope that's it. Let's go and figure it out.
Carl had seen that kind of safe before. With its double-layered security system blending letters and numbers, its code couldn't be broken by the common burglar.
Bingo. That worked. Wow. That's really cool. I wasn't sure if that's gonna work. Hey, but it did. What do we have here? Compromising document. Oh, William Hamilton is a crook. He has been blackmailing everyone. Oh, he has been blackmailing. And it looks like he's not only a crook, but also a murderer. That's what this document says. All right, what's that? Bertrand Lachance.
Many boxes scattered about. Carl didn't need to summon his detective training to quickly figure that the Lachances had just moved in. The general store, along with several more infrastructures in the area, had been acquired by wealthy industrialist William J. Hamilton. Perhaps the village should be rechristened Hamiltown.
Yeah, really. It looks like he was a real bad guy. Those poor people in this town.
What a mess. Clearly, there was some major revamping work underway here. The place looked barely habitable.
What's that? Polaroid film.
A nice white coating would restore the room to its charm of olden days.
Alright, what's in here? Cigarettes, again? I keep finding those cigarettes.
Beautiful portrait of Gilles and Giselle, bound together by the chains of conventional love.
box full of Harlequin novels.
Many boxes scattered about. Carl didn't need to summon his detective training to quickly figure that the LaChausses had just moved in.
Maybe they have. Maybe they just wanted to remodel. Who knows? We don't know anything since nobody is here besides this frozen statue, and that's supposed to be a woman, not a man like I originally thought. Okay, let's get out of here. Oh wow, it's dark. It's pitch dark. I didn't expect that. My god, it got dark really fast. But I guess that's how it is in winter, and it looks really cool here. That blue light, it's so atmospheric. What is this? Looks like some glowing arrow that someone shot into this post.
The crossbow bolt stuck into the wooden stairs reminded Carl of the arrow that was said to have hit Achilles' heel. But who was the intended Achilles this time?
Couldn't really see much on the photo. Guess I should have used the flash or something. Alright, so where do we have to go now? So there should be a house right on the other side of the street. Right across. I have to go downhill and to the right, I think. Can't really see much at all, but I think there's a mailbox, yeah. It's in here. Treasure map. Alright, this looks like the three houses that are north of the general store. I haven't been there yet, so there seems to be a treasure on the very, very far, next to the very, very far house on the right. I gotta remember that. And there's a number one, so there's probably another treasure map somewhere. What's this? Letter for Marie. My sweet Marie, may the treasure hunt begin. I have hidden wonderful little things for you to find all over the village following my clues. You are holding in your hands the first map. The hunt begins at my place. You are so clever, I'm certain you will find everything. All right, well, let's see how clever I am. It wasn't really meant for me, but I'm gonna go and find it. Now I'm just gonna have to find a house. Bedard's house. Okay, let's see what's hidden in this house. Looks like there's a shed. I'm gonna explore later. And a little bicycle. What's in here? Nothing at all. Oh, I can look into the room. It's like, looks like nobody's home. It's all dark. There's not really anything else here. So let's go inside, shall we?
Carl was no burglar. He didn't need to resort to petty techniques such as window breaking to find his way in. A good detective simply looks for keys where gullible souls hide them.
Where do people hide keys? Usually under pots, right? But it doesn't seem... Are those my footprints? I think so. There's another pot here. But I don't know. Can't move this pot. I don't really see anything where a key could be hidden.
Carl smiled at the sight of the nicely protected garden. Hopefully, the Bedards had managed to dig every last potato out before the sudden snowfall.
Oh well, we'll find the key. Maybe it's in the shed. That could be a total possibility. So let's just see what's in here. Lots of stuff. Looks like a garage, really. Oh, another empty bottle. Oh, my inventory is full. Oh, that really sucks. Does that mean... Oh, and look at that. A gas canister. I was looking for that all over, finally. So far away from the other house. Miles away from the other house.
A true Catholic always strives to keep lowly temptations at bay. Obviously, Carl thought, someone in this house wasn't doing a good job at upholding the Holy Bible's teachings.
Seems like there's a lot of stuff here that I can use or need, especially the gas canister. So I think I have to go and get my truck so I can dump some of the stuff in the truck bed and have more space in my bag again. That's really the only option. Oh, I made the mistake again of not bringing my car and had to walk miles just to get back to the store. But now we're here. All right, we're back with the truck now. So let's dump a lot of the stuff that I don't necessarily need right now in the truck bed and free up my bag. So what can we get rid of? Let's see. We can get rid of cigarettes, I think, matches, no. Hardware. Yeah, I guess. I feel like I need all of this stuff, but I just have to hope that my truck is nearby when I end up needing it. Revolver. Yeah, let's get rid of the cigarettes. I'm not sure what I would need those for. I'm gonna get rid of all of them. A log. Why would I carry a log around? Steak? Alright, water bottle. I'm not so sure what I need those for, okay. Duct tape, let's just keep one. Flare, pincher, fire starter. I think we're good with three. We don't need so much Polaroid film. And we don't need all matches, we can always get them. Alright, so I think we're good. But I actually need to go and get my hammer back because I should not have put that there. Because if I have to build something, I'd rather hold on to this. Alright, so now we should have plenty of room in my bag to pick up all the stuff that's in this garage. Who turned the light off? Turn the lantern on here, so let's get this. Oh, I'm really, really happy to finally have that gas canister so I can finally... Oh, a beer bottle. What do I need that for? I can finally build that snowmobile. What's that? Hardware? I think... Is that it? Isn't there something else? I think we have it all. All right, I think I'm done here. Still looking for the key. Where could it be? Oh, wait. Ha!
What was even the point of locking your door if everyone hid their key in the same place? Carl was starting to feel like his investigator life lacked challenge. The house smelled like incense, the kind that reminds you of the good Lord, of peace.
Enough food for rough times. Yeah, looks like it. Ooh, now we can see a much better look. That looks really cozy.
Religion was very influential throughout Quebec many years ago. Indeed, it was surprising that Carl did not come across a single chapel since arriving here.
Wow, lots of meat and cheese and Coke. More Polaroid film. Guess I have to make more photos. Is that a hint? Alright, let's close all those cabinets.
Good Paul Six, appearing papal. His crooked fingers gave the impression he was about to bestow a miracle.
Wow, those people are very religious. I guess that didn't help them with what's happened here. Can I watch some TV? Nope, TV is not working.
The perfect cookie-cutter Catholic family. Most likely attending church every Sunday.
Look at that. This house has light switches everywhere. What a concept.
Who knew that giraffes thrived in the North Pole? The craze for toys was stupefying. Love of religion and ancestors was rooted deep inside the hearts of Canadians of old, to which the Bedards appeared to be closely related. The family's mother must have spent her days washing the filth off her kids' diapers. The empty cradle sent an eerie feeling down Carl's spine. As if minutes ago, someone just grabbed the baby and made a run for it.
There's like nothing in this room. I don't think so, but there are two more rooms here. Oh, look, dream catchers. And a mess in the closet.
The Bedards had vacated the premises. Carl gathered they would be of no help.
Oh, it seems like Sylvie was pregnant and went to Dr. Beaupré, and that's where he found the blood of a young woman, so maybe that young woman was Sylvie. Some cute little drawings, works of art from a future artist. All right, some dolls, nothing really unusual. Can't really see anything in this closet, seems pretty much uninteresting. Seems like there's something to get in this closet, but I was wrong. Nope. Just making sure I didn't miss one thing here. Check the fridge and all those cabinets. And there's another door, that's just a side door. Don't need to go there, goes to the outside. So let's just go and leave this place. But where do we have to go next? We have to go to Roy, so we have to get out the driveway to the right. And then this, his house is at the right too. All right, let's do this. Probably close the door. Nope, it goes automatic. That's nice. Okay, we're here. It's another mailbox. Let's see if something is in that box. Dear Mr. Roy, I am writing this because I feel guilty. The other day, Martin and I were taking a stroll not far from your house and we saw that your door to your shed was open. I wanted us to mind our own business, but Martin likes living on the edge. He took a few shiny things, including some bullets. Now my dad always told me never to play with those things. Maybe we can find some bullets in this house. And who knows what. So let's go check this out. All right, we're here. I drove a little bit. I almost drove into the doghouse. But it doesn't seem like there's a dog here. Doesn't seem like anyone is here. Another dark house. Empty house. No dog. He would have come out by now. What's this? Oh, chair. Yeah, nobody there. Oh, wait, there was something. Oh, another empty bottle and a note. We fled. It was getting too dangerous. More people live in North Manistan. It will be safer there. Jeannie Roy. That's obviously the woman that used to live here.
It was a classic Canadian house, except for the absent horde of kids that would normally be swarming about.
Should I make a fire? Nah, I don't think it's worth it. Oh, look, a light switch. Yes, now we can see better.
Just one more move and White is checkmated. Game over. It seems the game was abandoned right before the final strike came down.
Wow, they must have really gotten out in a hurry.
Simone de Beauvoir, Claude Lévi-Strauss, Hannah Arendt, Roland Barthes. Carl was surprised by the literature filling this liberal-leaning bookcase. Could there really be intellectuals dwelling in this far-off land?
Wow, it says that Matthew wants to kill someone just for fun. Who is Matthew? Is that their son, or is that the father and husband? Not really sure, but it looks like he could be the killer, or at least the killer of Hamilton, maybe? Well, hopefully we find out soon. So maybe we can even get more clues in this house. Oh wait, there's some matches. Always good to have. Nope. Looks like the other fridge in the other house. Oh, that's just a side door. I was like, wait a minute. Nope, nothing.
The couple radiated something akin to lightheartedness, to freedom. Perhaps some people out there truly found a way to live happily ever after. A picture of Wilfred in his youth. Carl figured right away that the man must have been some kind of wildlife officer. The photograph was snapped not too far from here, Carl noticed. The couple seemed to be very good friends.
Ah, more painkillers. As if I didn't already have enough. Nope, There's nothing else here. Let's move on to the next room. This house looks exactly like the other house, some cookie cutter house. Oh, the fantasy page too. So Matthew met Beatrice and he really liked her. And he wanted her to be his victim. And he was contemplating a plan of killing her. Wow. Nothing else much here. Oh, look what we have here. Konopoli, that's funny.
All manners of clothing were gone, as if the Rois drove out of town with their closet in tow.
What do we have here? Ammo box. That must be the bullets that he was mentioning.
Not a single weapon was left. All of them were gone.
They forgot the bullets. Fantasy page 4. Did I miss page 3? Well, anyway, it looks like Matthew wanted to kill Beatrice right after marrying her, but he never did, and they had kids, and he's looking back off and thinking what would have happened if he killed her. Wow, what a sick person. Maybe that house is here somewhere. Oh, here's page 3. All right, we don't really have to read all this, I don't think so. We just know that his fantasy is killing Beatrice and he never really did it, which is good because I feel sorry for Beatrice not knowing about his dirty fantasies or sick fantasies. That's really creepy. There's nothing in this closet. Just a bunch of pictures here, probably Matthew. Oh, we can fill up our bottle right here. Let's do this, just in case. Never know. Nothing here. I'm done searching this place. It's hard to know when the closets that you open are closing itself. Yeah, I can't remember anymore what I searched, but I'm pretty sure I'm good. Alright, I think we're done here, south of the store. I can always come back if I forgot something, but right now I really just want to head up back up to the mechanic place to finish building my snowmobile and see what this is all about. So let's go. Man, that was a long drive. I hope it was worth it coming back here. I'm really, really curious to see how this goes now. I finally have that gas canister. I just have to fill it up with gas at the pump that I found here earlier. And then hopefully that works. All right. So we have gas in the canister, and that should be really it. Yes, that's it. We did it. We built the thing, and now we can drive it. Oh god, this thing doesn't drive. Ooh, that's very hard to maneuver around. Let's just take it for a test drive real quick and see how it goes.
The mechanic was still frozen, and Carl had everything he needed, so he felt ready to leave.
Yeah, but why do I need the snowmobile if I have the truck? Unless I have to get off-road somehow. But I don't think I'm gonna keep it because I have all my stuff in the truck bed. So I'm thinking I'm gonna park it here and take my truck. I like my truck better. I can always come back and get the snowmobile if I need it. I can't wait. I put so much work into this thing and now I'm not even using it. Oh well, I may come back. Bye, snowmobile. Alright, let's head to the houses that are northeast from the store that we haven't seen yet. Alright, we're back at the store. I'm gonna make a really sharp left turn here to get over this bridge. Hey, we made it. Alright, looks like we're here at Blair's house, the first house northeast of the store that we want to inspect, and it looks like there is light, so there may be someone home. I sure hope that guy doesn't have a gun.
A wintry atmosphere surrounded the house. The soundlessness of the area suggested it was empty.
Yeah, let's hope so. I feel awkward walking into people's houses and looking through all their stuff, especially if they're home. So I think I'm actually going to continue this tomorrow. I'm going to save this now right here. I'm going to warm myself up and then take a break.